Hello and welcome back. So today we are going to deal with a chapter, market mechanism. Here in this chapter we are going to understand the concept of the word equilibrium, and after that we are going to understand that how the equilibrium price and equilibrium quantity is determined in a perfectly competitive market. So let us start with the chapter and see the concept that we are going to get here. So as you can see in the first slide, we are going to first understand the meaning of the word equilibrium. In general, we say that equilibrium is nothing but equilibrium is a state of rest. That means what? That means that suppose if I take a test tube and if I take a small ball and if I drop that ball in a test tube, we are going to find that the ball will go first down and then again it will move up. So this upward and downward movement will continue for some time and finally the ball is going to come to rest at the base of the test tube. If you disturb the ball again, you will again find the same kind of movement of the ball and the ball will again come to rest at the same position. This is what actually the meaning of the word equilibrium. In simple word, if I say, then equilibrium is nothing but it is that position even when it is disturbed, we will return back to the same position. That is what we call equilibrium, or the meaning of the word equilibrium, right? Now, in economics, we do not mean the equilibrium as the example that I have given you. Here, when we talk about equilibrium, we talk about market equilibrium. And we say that market equilibrium is nothing but it is a situation where the forces of demand and supply act and react upon each other to determine the equilibrium price and to determine the equilibrium quantity of the good in the market. That is what the word equilibrium here means. So if you look at the second point, you're going to find it is written that equilibrium in the market is the situation where the market force of demand and supply. I hope you have already seen my videos on theory of demand and theory of supply, because you are going to find that I'm going to use lot of concept from those two chapters to deal or to understand the concept in this chapter, right? So, okay, let us again come back to the topic that I was telling. So I was telling that in economics, we say a market is in equilibrium when the demand is equals to the supply. So that is what actually called equilibrium position. So in other word, I can also say that equilibrium in an economy means the amount of commodity that is demanded by the consumer is equal to the amount of commodity that is supplied by the consumer. So that is what a state of equilibrium, that is demand equals to supply. And this situation of demand equal to supply actually help us to find out that what should be the equilibrium price in the economy and what should be the equilibrium quantity in the economy. So this entire mechanism of demand and the supply is nothing but what we say is called market mechanism. And here in this video, we are going to go through many graphs. We are going to read, we are going to understand those graphs, and let us find out that how this market mechanism principle work, right? So I'll proceed further. So you can see on your screen that the concept or the topic that we are going to deal here is equilibrium in a competitive market. So if we are dealing with a competitive market, that is perfectly competitive market, we know that following the law of demand. So following the law of demand, the demand curve is always downward sloping line. So if we are measuring quantity in the horizontal axis and if we measure price in the vertical axis, then the law, according to the law of demand, demand for any commodity will be a downward sloping line. And according to law of supply, the supply curve will be a upward sloping line. So this demand and the supply actually determines the equilibrium in the market. I just now told that equilibrium is nothing but equilibrium in economics means a situation where demand is equals to supply. And according to our diagram that we have here, we find that this is the point where the demand is equals to supply. So this is the only point in the diagram where I can see that the demand is equal to supply. And this is the point of equilibrium in the economy. So if I drop a perpendicular line like this to the quantity axis, I can get the equilibrium quantity of good that should be demanded and that should be supplied in the economy. Similarly, If I draw a parallel line like this, then I'm going to get the equilibrium price in the economy. So therefore, I can say that where the point where the demand and the supply intersect each other, that is the point of equilibrium, which determines the equilibrium price that need to be existed in the economy and the equilibrium quantity of output that need to be produced in the economy. So this is what actually the importance of concept of equilibrium, and this system is called market mechanism system. Right now, the point is, as I was telling, that equilibrium is a state of rest. So if you disturb the system, again the system will act and react, and it will come back to its initial position. That is what we have just now understood, what is actually equilibrium. So I'm going to deal with this. So as you can see here, so this is the analysis part. So here, point 3 and point 4 is a situation where I'm disturbing the market mechanism, and I can find out that the market will again come back to its initial position. Here also it is same. So these two point I will be discussing with the help of the graph that you see on the screen. So just imagine that instead of this price, if the price in the market is 50 rupees 50, that is this price. So what we find at this price, that consumer is going to demand this much amount of commodity, that is PD, because the demand is determined from the demand curve. So therefore, what I can see that when the price of the commodity is 50, the consumer will demand PD amount of, or PD quantity of good. And at the same time, when the price is 50, the producer using its supply curve is going to produce PS quantity of the good. So what you see that the quantity of supply is more than the quantity of demand. So, and if I ask that how much there is a excess of supply over demand, so it's very simple. So PS is the supply and PD is the demand. So if I subtract PD, I'm going to get that DS is the excess supply. So if there is excess supply in the economy, then what will be the action and reaction in the economy? So if the supply is more in the economy and the demand is less in the economy, this is directly going to affect the price. The producer is going to reduce the price to attract the consumer, right? So the price is going to fall. When the price falls, still there is an excess supply. So this process will continue till the price come back to its initial position of rupees 40. On the other hand, if I say that suppose if the price is rupees 30 in the market, what does it imply? It imply that now the total quantity of commodity that is demanded is PD is the total quantity demanded, and following the supply curve, the total supply in the market is PS. So at rupees 50, the quantity demand is more and quantity supply is less, and you can see very clearly from here that there is a excess demand in the economy. And what is that? SD quantity of the good is the excess demand in the economy. Now the question is how the market is going to act and react. The market, if this situation exists in the economy where demand is more and the supply is less, what we expect? We expect that the price of the commodity to rise, because the consumer is going to give or ready to pay more money for the commodity because there is a lack of commodity in the economy. So this situation will again force the price to rise in the economy. So we will this process will continue till we come back to the initial price of rupees 40. So what do you see that why we say that this is the equilibrium price and this is the equilibrium quantity? Because this mechanism work where excess demand is going to increase the price and excess supply is going to reduce the price in the economy, and the price is again going to come back to its initial position of rupees 40. So this is how the market mechanism keep on working, and we find that every time the market get disturbed, it come back to its initial position of state of equilibrium. So that is what actually the equilibrium means in the economy. And as I told you that what is the importance of intersection of demand and supply. So demand and supply intersection actually determine equilibrium price and equilibrium quantity. So hope you are getting my concept. So let us now move into some more topic and find out that if we disturb this economic system in a one way or other, then how this price, equilibrium price and equilibrium quantity to be produced is going to get affected. Right. So for this, I'll go for my first situation. So as you can see here, I'm taking V we are actually taking a first situation here where the situation is like this, that what will be the or how the equilibrium price and equilibrium quantity is going to change or is going to get affected when there is a case of decrease in demand. I hope you remember in theory of demand, I told the case of increase in demand and decrease in demand, extension in demand and contraction in demand. So please follow the word very carefully. This is a case of decrease in demand. And I hope you remember when there is a decrease in the demand curve shifts downward. And decrease in demand is nothing, but it is a situation where the demand curve shifts due to the change in factor other than price. So you have to remember or you have to recall all the concepts that you have learned in the theory of demand and in the theory of supply. So I want to see that how the equilibrium price and equilibrium quantity is going to get affected when there is a change in the when there is a decrease in demand. So as you can see here, again, we are taking quantity in the horizontal axis, price in the vertical axis. This is a normal supply curve, which is upward sloping, and D1 is my initial demand curve. So initially the demand curve was D1 and the supply curve was S. So the equilibrium was determined at this point, and according to this equilibrium, the quantity of the commodity that need to be produced is Q1 and the price to be charged was P1. So this is what actually the equilibrium price and equilibrium quantity from the initial situation. Now we are telling that if there is a decrease in demand, so if the demand decreases, that means what? The demand curve is going to shift downward. So now my new demand curve is due to D2, and from the demand curve D2, I can see the equilibrium point has shifted from this point to this point. And because of the shifting of the equilibrium point, now the demand and the supply intersect at this point where I can find the price is this, whereas the quantity is this. So what I can see? I can see that the equilibrium price has reduced, and at the same time equilibrium quantity has also reduced. So this show, or we can come to the conclusion, that if there is a decrease in the demand, then equilibrium price is going to fall, and at the same time equilibrium quantity will also fall, right? So this is one case. Let us move on to some more cases. So I'm taking just the opposite case here. As you can see here, now I'm taking a case where there is increase in demand. So supply is not changing, only the demand is changing. So if I take a situation like this, so increase in demand is a situation where the demand curve shifts upward. So if I take the initial supply curve as this and my initial demand curve as D, so you can very well see that initial demand curve and the supply curve intersect at this point. So the equilibrium price determined is P and the equilibrium quantity determined as Q. Now, if the demand curve increase and shift rightward or shift upward to the new position D1, then you can see that equilibrium or the intersection of demand and the supply is now determined at this point. And from this point, I can easily find out the equilibrium quantity and I can find out the equilibrium price. So what we can see from this diagram, that quantity demanded, equilibrium quantity has increased, and at the same time equilibrium price has increased. So what we have seen in both the diagram here, we have seen that when demand fall, there is a fall in the equilibrium price and fall in the equilibrium quantity. And in the next diagram, we have seen that if the demand increases, we have seen the price, equilibrium price also increases and equilibrium quantity also increases. So this is what actually we are trying to analyze, or we are trying to play with this situation of market mechanism by changing the demand and the supply, right? So now I can show you the third figure. As you can see the third figure here, the third case is a case where I'm taking a situation of increase in supply, and we know that when supply curve increases, supply curve move downward. So that is what we have seen in theory of supply, where I told that increase in supply means the supply curve is going to shift downward, right? So as you can see here now, so let us quickly have a discussion on this. So initially the demand curve, this time I'm not changing the demand curve, I'm only changing the supply curve, right? So the demand curve is D, whereas the supply curve is S, and the equilibrium is determined at this point. So from the equilibrium point, this I can very well see that the equilibrium quantity initially was Q1 and the equilibrium price is P1. What happened now? The supply has increased. Increase in supply means the supply curve is going to shift downward. So if the supply curve shifts downward, then I can see that the new supply curve and the initial demand curve, now they intersect at this point. And from this situation, we can see that equilibrium quantity is now Q2 and the equilibrium price is P2. So what we find here, we find a little different result than the cases that we have seen previously. So now we see that due to increase in supply, the equilibrium quantity increases, but equilibrium price fall. So we find a little different type of case here where the quantity is increasing and at the same time the equilibrium price fall from P1 to P2. So this is another case. So you all can practice all such cases. I can give you some situations. So in the video, we will see different situations and we'll try to find out that how, right? I'm taking another case. So this is a case where we can discuss about decrease in supply, where the demand remains same. So as you know that when the supply curve fall or decreases, we see that the supply curve shift upward. So again, using the same logic, so this is the initial supply curve and we are having only a single demand curve. Both of them intersect at this point. So accordingly, the equilibrium quantity is Q1 and the equilibrium price is P1. So now if I say that there is a case of decrease in supply, so this supply curve is going to shift upward to the new position called S2. And from this S2 supply curve, I can see that it is intersecting with the demand curve at this point. So the equilibrium point has now changed. And because of the change in the equilibrium point, we find that the equilibrium price has increased from P1 to P2 and the equilibrium quantity has decreased. Again, you find a little different situation, right? So in this case, the price is rising, but the equilibrium quantity is falling. So this is again one of the conclusion that we get. So I've taken four cases. So let me just quickly show you. So initially we have discussed that how the equilibrium price and equilibrium quantity is determined. Then what we have done, we have little bit disturbed the system and we try to find out that how, what is the effect of disturbing the market mechanism. So what we can find here, so when there is a case of decrease in demand, both price and equilibrium quantity fall. When there is a case of increase in demand, both equilibrium price and equilibrium quantity increases. But when there is an increase in supply, we find that the equilibrium price fall, but equilibrium quantity increases. And if we take the case of decrease in supply, then we find that the equilibrium price increase, that is from P1 to P2, but equilibrium quantity falls. So this is what actually just opposite that is taking place. So these are the four special cases that I have actually taken to make you understand that how this market mechanism work and how the equilibrium price and quantity get affected when there is a change in demand or change in supply. Change means it can increase, it can decrease. Now the question is, which we are going to deal, that what will happen to the market or to the equilibrium price and quantity if there is change in both demand and supply, right? Hope you are getting my question. So my question to you is that how the equilibrium price and quantity is going to change when there is a change in both demand and supply. So both are changing simultaneously. Then how we are going to find out that what will be the effect on the equilibrium price and quantity. So let's have a discussion. So you can see here. Now I'm taking a case where I'm taking a case of increase in both demand and supply. I'm taking a case where both demand as well as supply. So both are increasing simultaneously. So when I'm telling that both are increasing simultaneously, there can be further three cases. You can see very clearly on the screen that increase in both demand and supply mean that both demand and supply is increasing in equal magnitude. What do I mean here? I mean that suppose I'm saying that demand has increased. So if the demand increased by 2 unit and the supply also increased by 2 units, so this is my first situation where increase in demand is equal to increase in supply, both are increasing by 2 units. But if I am saying that suppose if the demand increased by 4 units and the supply increased only by 2 units, so here also we see that both demand and supply is increasing, but the magnitude of increase in demand and supply is not same, right? Again, I am repeating, please listen carefully. I am saying that we are dealing with a situation of increase in demand and increase in supply. But this increase can be further subdivided into three parts. So first is demand has increased by 2 units, supply has also increased. So equal increase, right? Next I'm telling that demand has increased by 4 unit and the supply has increased only by 2 units. So both are increasing, but the increase in the magnitude is not same. Demand is increasing more than supply. And finally, the third we are telling that the demand is increased by 2 unit and the supply increased by 6 unit. So here also both are increasing, but increase in supply is more than increase in demand. So if these are the cases, then how the equilibrium price and equilibrium quantity are going to get affected, that is what we are going to see from the three diagram that you see on your screen, right? So as you can see clearly that this is the first diagram that I have taken where this is a case of equal increase in demand and supply. So I am taking the case of equal increase. So if the demand increased by 2, supply is also increasing by 2. So this is my first case. So if this happened, how we are going to study the graph? So please follow the graph very properly. So let us take this as my initial demand curve D and this as the initial supply curve S. So the initial demand and initial supply intersect at point E. So my equilibrium quantity is Q and equilibrium price is P. Now what happened? Now the both demand and the supply is increasing by same magnitude. So the demand has increased from D to D1 and the supply has increased from S to S1. So now what I can see that the initial supply, that is the final supply curve, is S1 and the final demand curve is D1. So the point where the present supply curve and the present demand curve intersect, that will determine the equilibrium point in the market. So now we can see the equilibrium is determined at the point E1, and according to point E1, you can very well see that the equilibrium price remains same, but equilibrium quantity has now changed to Q1. So what we can say from here, that equilibrium price remains same, but equilibrium quantity has increased. So this can be one case where we are talking about increase in both demand and supply, but by equal magnitude. Now, just have a look to the second diagram. So from the second diagram itself, you can see very well that in this case, we are saying that the demand has increased more and the supply has increased less. And that is why the shift of the demand, just see the shift of the demand is this much, whereas the shift of the demand is only this much. Supply, only the shift of the supply is only this much. So now how we are going to study, just have a look and just follow my word. Here we can see the demand curve is D initially and the initial supply curve is S. So the point where the demand and the supply intersect, that determines the point of equilibrium. So according to this situation, what we can see here, the equilibrium is at point E. So equilibrium price is P and the equilibrium quantity is Q. Now what happened? The demand has increased. What happened? Supply has also increased, but demand has increased more than supply. So therefore, the new demand and the new supply intersect at point E, and E is the new point of equilibrium. According to this new point of equilibrium, what we can find, the equilibrium quantity has increased from Q to Q dash, whereas price has also increased from P to P dash. Just look into the difference between these two diagram. So if you look into the difference between these two diagram, then it's only because of the difference in the magnitude of change. We see that in first case, there is no change in equilibrium price. But here in this case, we see that the equilibrium price as well as equilibrium quantity has changed. It has increased. Whereas if you look into the third diagram, here also we are talking about increase in both demand and supply, but increase in supply is more than increase in demand. And that can be easily seen from the shift of the supply curve. So see here, the supply curve is shifting from S to S dash, whereas demand curve is shifting from D to D1. So again, if you look, then this is the demand curve in initial supply curve and the equilibrium is at point E. So the price is P and the quantity is Q. Now, the demand has increased, the supply has also increased, and I can see very well that the new supply curve and the new demand curve intersect at the point E1. And because of this, that is E1, we can see the equilibrium quantity is now at Q1 and the equilibrium price is P1. So what you can see here, that if this situation take place, then we can very well say that equilibrium quantity has increased, but equilibrium price fall. So please follow. So my point is that if there is an increase in both demand and supply, then we find three cases are there. Suppose if I say, or if I give you a home task, that if there is a decrease in both demand and supply.
So if both demand as well as supply decreases, then again there will be three cases: that demand and supply is decreasing by equal magnitude, or I can say decrease in demand is more than decrease in supply, or I can say decrease in demand is greater than decrease in supply. So you are going to get further three cases here in the case of this. We can have some more cases like this, that suppose what will happen to the equilibrium price and equilibrium quantity if demand is increasing but the supply is falling. That can be also one case. So demand, this time the demand is rising and supply is falling. There can be one more situation where we can say that the demand fall but the supply increases simultaneously. So there, like this, there can be several situations, and we have to find out that how the equilibrium price and the quantity is going to get affected when we are talking about such situations, right? So in some of my more videos, I am going to deal with all such cases with the help of the graph. So you keep on practicing the graph so that you can you do not do any mistakes in your examination, and I hope you are going to practice this diagram, because in this chapter practicing the diagram and explaining the diagram is most important. So we'll continue further with some more topic in some more videos. Thank you.